The rocket builds and launches you're about to see were all supervised by a safety professional. They're extremely dangerous and should not be attempted by anyone, any place, any time. I'm an ordinary man with an explosive obsession. My name is Dan Stroud, and I am a rocketeer. 10 years ago, my son Terry and I launched our first rocket. Since that defining blast, we've dedicated our lives to becoming the world's best rocketeers. Terry and I left our everyday lives behind in our quest to compete against the most innovative minds on the planet. Each week, we face a new team and a fantastic challenge.
How the heck do you expect us to do these things?
We push imagination to the limit because we will out-design, out-build, and outperform our competition. Both teams work in secrecy for 4 days. Then, we reveal our creations to each other and the world. It's the ultimate test of ingenuity, innovation, and imagination.
Holy cow!
But on launch day, only one team will emerge victorious.
That's scary!
For Terry and me, every day is a race against the clock.
We're almost out of time!
And the laws of gravity.
Watch out!
We can prove we're the best. We do have the right stuff. We are the Master Blasters. I'm Dan Stroud. I'm the head of the Master Blasters, along with my son, Terry Stroud.
My dad and I have never, ever lost. Ever.
This week, the Master Blasters are taking on a very famous Kai Michelson and the Rocket Man team.
You guys have flown into space.
They have flown into space, and you have to give them that.
My name is Kai Michelson. I'm the lead on Team Rocket Man. I've been blessed to had the opportunity to actually build a rocket as a civilian, and we actually put a rocket into space. It went 72 miles up at the speed of 3,420 miles an hour, and I'll tell you what, it was a thrill of my life.
Terry and I are excited to go up against the Rocket Man team because we want to go up against the best.
We're Team Rocket Man. We're here to challenge.
As far as I'm concerned, we're Team Rocket Man, but we are the masters of rockets. And you will soon find that out.
We're the Master Blasters, and we accept that challenge. And all of a sudden, down the runway comes a band, a marching band. The marching band is great.
We got a challenge briefcase.
Thank you.
With our instructions.
Your challenge is to launch a rocket-powered field goal. But in Master Blasters football, we don't play with a pigskin. We play with brand new sports cars. The team that launches the longest winning field goal wins the challenge. This week's challenge is to launch a small sports car through a set of field goals 1,000 feet away. You guys understand the challenge?
Yeah, we understand the challenge. See, this has something to do with football. The loser throws a tailgate party.
I hope they can cook good, buddy.
If there's anything Texas is known for, it's football and tailgate parties.
Yes.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Yeah.
Yep. Good luck.
Go get them.
The teams will spend the next 4 days working inside this 10,000 square foot rocket lab. This state-of-the-art facility is divided into three sections. In the front is the machine shop. In this common area, both teams will have access to these high-powered tools. Behind the shop are the private team work areas. A dividing wall ensures teams will work in complete secrecy from each other while we build our rockets. Oh, big group this week. We got a big project to build, guys. We only got 4 days to get it done. So we're burning daylight. Let's get after it.
Wow. This is something.
She's a beauty.
A rocket car.
A rocket
in the
car.
Making.
Oh, man, look at that. Oh, this is going to be a lot of fun.
There we go.
How about a wing, some type of airfoil or wing?
My name is Jody Michelson. Kai is my husband. We've been married for 13 years. In 1995, I launched a rocket. It went 31,185 feet. It was the woman's altitude record.
You're going to be the welder on this project, Joe?
I'm the welder and the tube bender.
Really?
It's fun working with my wife anytime. Her and I have a good time together.
Our children, their middle names have Rocket in it. We have a boy named Buddy Rocketman Michelson, but our girl's name is also Miracle Rocket Michelson.
You got a lot of work to do on this thing, that's for sure. And we don't have much time to do it.
Looky here. Oh, looky, looky, looky.
Coming into our shop, we got to see the premier small German-made sports car that we're gonna get to use.
Hey, Dano, I see a problem right now. We gotta do something about the speedometer. It just says 150.
I see the car, I thought, how cool is this? We're making a car into a rocket.
We're building a mount to go in here, and in there houses our super secret rocket power. I'm leading the charge on the whiteboard. I'm actually summarizing everybody's input.
We need to contain our rocket thrust, so we're building the cage to hold our rocket motors. Then we're gonna build a tail boom that extends out the back to hold some fins.
And everybody feels good?
Yeah.
Plan.
We're here for one reason, and that's to beat the Master Blasters. And here's my plan.
Kai and I sometimes have a little difference of opinion. Kai usually wins.
Unlike mounting a rocket right in the very back like you do a conventional rocket, we're gonna mount these rockets in this area.
Instead of putting the rockets in the back of the car to push the car, we decided to put the rockets in the front of the car to pull the car.
Anybody's got any questions at all here?
Yeah, where are we gonna put the third rocket motor?
I
am Bruce Lee. That's my real name. It's just funny how it turned out that I ended up with a name that was famous. Hey-ya! They consider me the math wizard guy. Actually, my dad took me out to see Sputnik in 1957 at the age of 5, and that's where my fascination with rockets started.
I haven't been thoroughly convinced on putting the third motor in, but it may happen. Got any other questions?
If somebody else gets a good idea, other than probably be Kai's name that goes on the idea.
All right, let's get to work.
Sometimes I do get a little one-sided because when I make up my mind that we're going to head one way, that's the way we go.
We'll start assigning out what we're going to do, and we're going to go for it. Simple as that.
Can that's right.
Suggestions?
Yeah.
Why don't you two start drawing some pictures and some diagrams?
Okay.
Let's get the rest of us five guiding.
That's a great idea.
I'm Eric Gates. You might have seen me on the Rockaholic team as their team captain, and now I've been recruited as a Master Blaster.
We were very impressed by him. He nearly kicked our butts. And now we want him as one of our teammates.
I started out doing rockets as a kid with my dad, and then when I grew up and I had kids of my own, we started doing rockets with them as well, kind of as an excuse for us to do them.
Good idea.
Okay.
I'm feeling, I'm ready.
We'll start stripping and then stop and talk.
There's one thing we knew with no debate that we were gonna have to do. It was strip that car and get that sucker to its minimum weight.
One down.
19 inches, T.
19, okay.
Once we walked into that room, we saw the car. Hey, we just looked at each other. We got to get to work, and boom, everybody jumped inside.
Man, is this ever stiff?
My name is Jim Hoffman, a rocketry. There's so much to it. It's just a blast.
You got screws right here.
You guys ever work at a chop shop before?
No. No, but I've built many a stock car.
My name is Dave Leininger. On our team, I've kind of been the weight engineer. I know a lot about taking cars apart.
We're going to beat the Master Disasters, and we're going to show them that the crew from Minnesota is the true champions.
So I want to get this straighter here yet, though. This is sitting like this. I want to get this straighter, a little bit straighter. I don't like crooked things.
It's really hard to explain the talent that I have, but I have a total mechanical photographic mind, and I can say this will work. It's an unbelievable talent that I'm blessed with.
Only then make sure it's straight. I don't want nothing crooked on this car. I want it to look nice.
You may notice that Kai's got a little bit of an ego. But now's when we find out who really is the best. So if you beat the guy who's flown into space, who do you top after that?
Coming up on Master Blasters.
There's a ramp.
Holy cow! Yeah.
The guy's had a little accident.
First thing I saw was an arm coming towards me.
No, medic, medic, medic.
T, looky here. We came in this morning and we see a guy in the football uniform. He's there to give us a new challenge.
This week, the Master Blasters are taking on a very famous Kai Michelson and the Rocket Man team. If there's ever a team that deserves accolades, it is definitely the Rocket Man team.
Oh my God, what do we got here? Football player. How you doing?
The challenge is we're taking a car, a sports car, we're modifying it so we can fly it like a rocket and try and put it through a goalpost on a football field.
Well, Kai came up with a side bet to take on these guys, and it was for a tailgating party.
In Master Blaster Football, the car must return safely to the Earth, design a recovery system that will ensure your vehicle will come back without a scratch.
We have to change everything. We got to throw out a really heavy parachute. It changes everything dramatically, but we can handle it. It's no big deal. We weren't expecting it. They have to handle this really giant parachute.
Oh.
Apparently, as always, things are a little different than we first expected.
Design a recovery system that will ensure your vehicle will come back without a scratch. We've got to parachute this damn thing in.
A really big parachute.
They want to recover this thing. Well, you know, it was one thing launching the thing and get through the goalpost, but now we got to bring it back in one piece. It put us at a little more stress, I think.
We got a lot of work to do. Let's think about it, and we'll come back a little bit and talk about it.
I'm smelling shooting. It's got Eric's name all over
it. You bet it, buddy. Eric, old buddy,
you're smelling shoot.
So with this new twist now, my expertise comes into play because I'm a recovery expert. I skydive, I base jump, and parachutes is my game.
With our man Eric here, let me tell you, we've got a definite advantage on this thing.
We have a Texas-sized load this week as crew members. These are some guys that get stuff done.
Okay, there we go.
Pat's worth two people, three people, 4.5 people. Man, he's an amazing guy.
I am working on the tail section boom mounting assembly.
If you're gonna assemble a Master Blaster's A-team, you have to include Jimmy.
I'm Jimmy Franz from Ponder, Texas. Yep.
If you go a whole number, you've moved a great amount.
Yeah, if I go 8 inches, that'd give me.
You gotta have Butch. There is no substitute for Butch.
I think this launch is gonna be our best. We put our heads together pretty good on it, and yeah, we're gonna kick butt Friday.
I'm gonna be leaving you guys for about 3 hours.
Okay. We'll get going on boom and all that kind of stuff.
A member from both teams will each have 1 hour to scout the launch ramp. Observing the ramp may cause the teams to rethink their rocket designs.
Well, I hear they got a ramp built for us out here.
My name is Bruce Kelly, and I'm more of the gopher for our team.
It's going to be 60 foot long, 40-degree angle, so it'll be fun to see what they got going out there.
There's a ramp. It's huge. 40 degrees, 60 foot long, is a lot bigger up close than it is on paper.
It looks real steep.
Yeah. It's a lot bigger than I envisioned. You know, 60 feet at a 40 degree angle, you don't quite get the concept until you see it actually built. I figure we're gonna land right where that dirt patch is right there.
That's about right.
Should be interesting.
I think that we can actually do it. I think that we'll actually be able to get the car off and to make the distance that we need to clear the goalpost. I photographed the tower from all sorts of different angles. I've talked to the people who are constructing the tower. Now I'm going to go back and show the photos that I've taken to the rest of the team and explain to them how I feel the tower's going to function.
You guys got to check this out.
Was it cool?
Scared the hell out of me.
Really?
Eric came back from his little reconnaissance mission to take a look at the ramp, make sure everything was going good and that we're not aimed at Oklahoma. Brought pictures to show us how colossal and mega amazing this thing is.
Well, that's something else to keep me up tonight.
Well, how'd it go?
Well, really good.
What do we got going here? Hey, Jody, come on over here.
It was exactly what we expected to be. Our goal is going to be to get our rocket-powered car from the end of that ramp through some goalposts.
Personally, I think, guys, we're on the right track with our design. I don't know what they're doing, but, you know, I'm hoping they're going to go with the conventional, put the motors in the back. We got ours up front. We got our weight where it should be. This thing should be like a torpedo. So let's get to work.
All right.
I got a little present for the Master Blaster. See, they're going to lose. I know they're really concentrating on their car right now, but what they really need to start thinking about concentrating is on steaks. Because that's what we're planning on eating, steaks. The loser throws a tailgate party. It's barbecue time!
What's this?
What's this?
Pink in the middle, lightly seasoned.
Well, we want a better grade of steak than that. Retaliate, the guy's kind of cooked up a big steak here for him.
Incoming!
Hey! Great job, just the way I like it. Serious, the thing is great. It tastes like buffalo meat that's been in a fire for a long time. I can also taste a little bit of the acetylene, so I don't think it was done over a pit.
All right, gang, I know we got a hell of a lot of work to do to get these rockets ready.
We had a little bit of a problem. Something big happened. I heard this big blast.
Coming up on Master Blasters.
Those rocket motors are used to power Tomahawk cruise missiles.
Good friend and a great rocketeer was injured today.
Someone must have touched it somewhere, or leaned on it, or did something.
And the car started rolling back, so almost fell off of the work platform here.
That's scary.
I was welding a piece of a tubing on the car. I was on the far back where the cages and fins are, and all of a sudden it just fell. And I had my arm under the cage, and I was kind of in it, and I was kind of out it. I noticed it was just about to go off. It did. And I caught it and pushed it back up on the stands where it was just one of them freak accidents falling off the scales. I could have got hurt.
Hey, guys, it's time to cut out of here.
You know what I like about this is we got a lot done yesterday. This week's challenge is to launch a small sports car through a set of fuel goals 1,000 feet away. Then we have to recover it safely.
All right, it's a new day here, guys. We'll sit back where we're at. Jim, you're going to be working on the motor mount this morning?
I do know that the Master Blasters have got a lot of talent. They know what they're doing. That's why they're here. That's why they're the Master Blasters. And what we have to do is show the world that we are the king of them Master Blasters.
This is going to look as cool as it's going to be cool.
Oh. Hook up your sensors.
In the center. Eric,
I've been seeing them hauling a bunch of material back from the common area, and I keep thinking, boy, look at all that weight. They're doing something different than we are. Either that or they're making steel easy chairs to sit on at the launch site.
And here it comes. We came out with 2,050 pounds, and then we're going to add in the last little bit, so we're figuring 2,100 pounds is the final weight.
At this point, weight is everything. See, that's right front. Okay, gotcha.
1307.
Ooh, you're the best. This is going to be nice.
We're 1307 after making our modifications.
Hey!
Kai, I got presents.
Hey, guys. We're actually going to use this for pulling our parachute out. We're going to put this in a cannon. And on top of that, we're going to mount a helmet. We're going to have a football helmet bowling ball pull our chute out.
We got a mannequin that we're going to put at the top of the bowling ball cannon, and he's going to come shooting out when we eject the parachute.
Okay.
It doesn't fit.
Hey, bud. Oh, is that what I think it is? Oh, yeah. This is by far the biggest motor we've used on Master Blasters.
Dude. That's the business end, right?
Yeah, that's a business end, all right. Hoo-yah! Oh, that's motor. I don't know that a medium-sized motor is going to satisfy us anymore.
Yeah, that's what my wife says. I've been
with you. Oh, Carbon, look at this, guys.
Those motors kick out 2,500 pounds of thrust. That's a ton plus another 500 pounds of thrust each. And we found out that those rocket motors are used to power Tomahawk cruise missiles. These things are going to go screaming.
This really kicks some butt.
You have to remember one thing. A rocket is nothing more than a controlled explosion. That's all it is. And if that nozzle is not right, or that orifice isn't right, if it's too small, there's problems. Who knows? It wouldn't be the first rocket motor that ever blew up if one of them blew up.
It's a great toy, though. Boy, I'd love to have a box full of these.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You can have one for now.
Well, that's going to be wood, though. It's going to be over here, right?
Yeah.
Drat! I was hoping it was going to be metal. I love sparks.
Well, no, we can get some sparks. It's the final day. It's going to be a rush to the finish. Yep. Here we go again.
60 minutes, guys. 60 minutes to showtime. The most important thing right now is to get the motors mounted onto the...
Well, it can go any length you want, buddy, so...
It's the last build day, and everybody's running around like crazy. I'm excited on the last day just to see what they have built over there, because, you know, they're busy as we are.
I'm sure that the Master Blasters are curious as to what we built. The reason I'm curious to see what they've built is to see how right I am.
We're up against some of the best rocketeers in the United States, and if you beat the guys who flew into space, then you're number one, right?
My guess is it's not going to look much like a normal car. You know, their car looks remarkably like a car. It wasn't until we started walking around it that we saw that they had done a substantial amount of work to it, really.
It's going to have a hard time flying. It's just pulling.
Their balance isn't right. That car is going to go whoop.
It was amazing how we weren't, you know, all pointing and staring and talking about it. We were all just kind of puzzled as to what it was supposed to do.
Kai's pretty innovative guy, so... there's something to it.
Well, I'm sure we were all curious as to what the Master Blasters were building. We were quite sure it wasn't going to be anything like we were doing.
I'm a little concerned about the motors being in the back here. 4,500 degrees in the thrust.
Wrong.
I really didn't think it was going to fly.
And all the windows are out, so that's going to cause a lot of turbulence.
It's all wrong. We got 60
no, it, ramp, it, the whole vehicle is wrong. It's just not the way that I would have built, and it's the way we didn't build our vehicle.
Okay, gang, we launch tomorrow, early in the morning.
And don't forget the bet. I want my steak medium well.
Good luck.
Coming up on Master Blasters.
Launch day. Let's get after it.
It's kind of like a Texas shootout, you know?
So the countdown starts and man, you feel it. I mean, everybody's twinging.
We are firing a beautiful little sports car right through a field goal, and we have to try to safely recover the car.
All right, guys, launch day. Got a great day here. Let's get after it.
We're ready. See you at chow line tonight.
Well, this is really what it's all about.
Here we go, guys.
We're getting ready to start prepping.
All right, where'd my box of electronics go? Okay.
Woo!
I test the electronics and the timing was slightly off, so we're gonna do another test.
Really excited, I'm ecstatic. I can't wait until it's time to launch.
It just looks like such a toy. I mean, this thing, you know, it just looks like a cool toy.
All righty. Hey, buddy. We're here. It's a good day, you know? So, got the breeze in our face. I think it'll help. So, good luck, buddy.
It's kind of like a Texas shootout, you know?
Yeah, that's right.
It's kind of like high noon.
It's pretty close.
Is it?
Let me look.
Yeah, go back.
We're ready.
Bring it up.
Yeah, we're ready. Anything we do to get this thing up. I try to be really safety conscious, you know, because safety is first. And I've been around way too long to know just the littlest thing's going to get you.
We're okay.
I'm getting nervous.
This is gonna be cool.
We're tying in the motors to the timer, and somewhere along the line, we triggered the timer on, which was a 4.5 second timer.
And we hear a gigantic boom. Air goes up on our necks, you know, because, man, it was a thunderous explosion.
Everybody okay?
I know, sir.
No, medics.
Medics. What the hell, buddy?
Keys right now.
First thing I saw was an arm coming towards me. And the next thing I saw was one of our team members, Bruce Lee, coming over, holding on to his hand, and he had blood dripping from his hand. I immediately found something to wrap with and applied pressure to the pressure points.
It's just a pipe in me. I'm going to pop it off. I don't know what happened. It was flashing.
I'll tell you what, when that thing went off, I turned, saw a ball of smoke, and I seen an arm flying at me. I mean, it was the arm off the mannequin, and I knew it was, but you know, then Bruce backs out of the car and he was just bleeding profusely.
Is that anywhere else?
Nope.
Oh. Yeah, I got a he's an arterial bleed.
There was quite a bit of blood, so EMTs did show up right away. They were right on scene and whisked him off to get his arm fixed.
Dangerous, but man, I hate to see somebody get hurt.
Hey, I just think.
Get hit in the chest or the head.
Good friend and a great Rocketeer was injured today. He should be standing at the table with us while we launch it. I know he'd like us to launch it.
Coming up on Master Blasters.
This is for our good buddy, Bruce Lee, buddy.
The old saying, the show must go on, and the team decided we're going to fly this thing anyways.
Okay, we're going to arm 2-1. There we go.
Kai and the guys are putting the car on the ramp. The guys had a little accident.
The rocket team was setting up their charge. I think that the static electricity from the steel and the wiring ignited it, and it blew.
There was quite a bit of blood, so EMTs did show up right away. They were right on scene and whisked him off to get his arm fixed. It sounds like he's going to be okay. He has a few stitches in his arm, and you'll be back out to fly rockets with the rest of us.
Scared the absolute hell out of me. Bruce is going to get his arm sewn up. He should be fine.
Got a friend of ours got hurt. You know, accidents happen. He should be standing right alongside of me.
The old saying, the show must go on, I decided, and the team decided we're going to fly this thing anyways.
Bruce is just like the rest of us. We are true breed Rocketeers, you know.
He'd be disappointed if we didn't launch.
Oh, no, we'd never hear the end of it. We'd never hear the end of it. He wants us to.
For our good buddy, Bruce Lee, buddy. To win the challenge, Team Rocket Man must launch their sports car as far as possible. The car must also go through the goalpost and land safely under parachute.
Okay, we're going to arm. Every time I do a countdown, my heart starts pounding. I get pumped. 10, 9.
We've been working on this thing for a week. I mean, we want to see this thing fly.
6, 5.
I started to get very nervous, and when the countdown got to about 5.
3, 2, 1.
There we go.
One motor lit.
Oh my God,
one motor lit.
Oh, no.
The motor burning on the ground.
I saw we were in trouble right off the bat. They had one motor pushing in the wrong direction, and the other, there was no motor to counteract, and all we had was a big pinwheel. And there was parts shredding off that car just from spinning.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, it was spectacular.
That was great.
That's the part of rocketry that's so cool, you know, because you just really never really know what's going to happen. It took off that ramp, I mean, it. It was really cool. It was spinning pretty fast. That was fun, but it's kind of a letdown that it didn't work. But you know, the thrill was still there. It looked great coming off the ramp, and that's what makes, you know, we're all happy. I you can ask any of the guys. You know, it was fun, and that's what it's all about. I saw a vehicle on four wheels. I was pretty happy with the whole thing. I said, hey. Maybe we'll win by default just because our vehicle looks pretty good.
You know, as bad as this whole thing looks, if I was going to build another one, I'd do it almost exactly the same way.
They provide the motors for us. They provide a very good product. I spoke to the president of the company, and he's upset, very, very upset about it because of the fact that there was a failure with that motor.
The old saying is sometimes you eat the bear and sometimes the bear eats you, and this is a day when we got eaten to death with a grizzly.
Team Rocket Man launched their sports car 132 feet. They did not split the uprights, and they did not recover the car safely.
We got a little bit of fun with the parachute after the launch. We needed to clean the area up, so we inflated the parachute, and the car was dragged off the field with the parachute.
The car took off, and the parachute took off, and everybody else took off.
Out of its way!
Bobby. Oh, man. Yep.
coming up on Master Blasters.
This works in two modes.
You know you did everything right, but still.
It's our turn. Now we're on the line.
Trust the thrust.
Okay!
Gaff tape instead, maybe?
Yeah, gaff tape since our duct tape's gone.
This week's challenge is a small sports car through a set of field goals 1,000 feet away.
Then
we have to recover it safely. The side wager is you've got to have a tailgate party. You've got to supply the tailgate party for the winning team. Let's just fly this baby.
The Rockyman's car went and left the ramp when it was doing beautifully, and then it starts spinning like a top and getting that distinct noise, and crashes down 2/3 of the way to the goal. It was very cool, actually. It was actually pretty cool. You know, there's not many times that you get to see a car up in the air spinning like a top. This works in two modes. It works with you where you break the tripwire or where you close the circuit. It's launch day, and I'm still, my head's whizzing with all the details.
Okay, why don't
you know, a lot of people have spent a lot of time and spent a lot of money to make this thing happen, so I suppose I'm worried that it won't.
Get out of the way, buddy.
We're trying to get ready to go ahead and launch the car. You know, we're excited about it, but now we have a little bit of doubt, fear, and dread. You know, what happened to them could very well happen to us. But if it doesn't, yeah, we got them whipped.
Well, good luck.
Yep, thank you.
I want to see one fly really good.
To win the challenge, my Master Blasters must launch our sports car as far as possible. The car must also go through the goalpost and land safely under parachute.
It's our turn. Now we're on the line. We have to prep it, we have to get it on the rail, and we have to launch it.
It's still not super simple, do it every day type of operation to get a car onto a 40 degree ramp to launch it with military grade motors, but we did it pretty quick and pretty well, actually, because we had thought it all out.
There she goes. Team was like clockwork, put the tail end on it, bolted it in place, and next thing you know, we're wiring her up.
I see. Okay, I feel better now. I'll be able to sleep tonight.
Trust the thrust.
Trust the thrust. That's an... Oh, I love it, buddy.
We'll launch this one for old Bruce, too. All righty, gang.
That's right.
You know you designed it right. You know you did everything right. But still, you're launching a car. 10, 9, so the countdown starts, and man, you feel it. I mean, everybody's twinging. 5.
Oh, please, please let it happen.
3, 2, 1. Go, Terry! Woo!
You did it.
Field goal.
I'm in here.
Oh, looky here. Hey.
Yeah, I love that referee. He's a good man.
That launch was amazing. That was exactly as predicted. I mean, the flight was awesome. It just kept going and kept going. That thing just went beautifully. Just like the diagrams I'd come up with, just according to simulation. It noses down the exact way I predicted. Just the most amazing thing in the world. I mean, I don't know how many cars you see at 230 feet traveling 175 miles an hour. I've only seen one, and it was effing cool.
Spectacular flight. They did a good job. They did their homework. Everything went well for them. The motors worked.
Son of a bitch. The flame blew out of that thing. Blasted right out through, tunneling behind the fins, like we said, and straight off the ramp it goes. That sumbitch soars over the goalpost, way over the goalpost, way downrange. I mean, 100 yards, hell,
We went over a quarter of a mile.
You take a car and you launch it through the air, and that's absurd. Oh my God. All right, we screwed up the recovery. So what? You know, I thought back about it later and I'm like, you know, we messed up the recovery. We should have set our timers for 3 seconds. And then I'm like, but then we wouldn't have got to see what we saw.
Whoa. There's a little bit of energy there, you think?
Now, where's the other?
I've never seen such total destruction in my life.
Photo op, 1, 3.
We went a quarter mile. That's 1/4 mile in the air.
You know what? The only way I know this is a hood is because I painted that football on it.
Take the weight out, make it stable. You can go a long, long ways. That's exactly what we said. It's exactly what it did.
No, this was definitely the coolest one.
Well, you know, the 4 cars that you and I did, Pat, last year.
Yeah.
This is the Master Blasters A-Team. Everybody had contributed something that made this operation very easy.
My Master Blasters launched our sports car 1,441 feet. We did split the uprights, but we failed to recover the car safely.
This launch by this Master Blasters team is how the best amateurs in the world do it.
Oh, I'm mighty hungry for some steak. Steak, baby. We said steak, we meant steak.
When I saw that thing come off the ramp, I knew Kai was cooking burgers. And we went through the goalpost, and so far downrange, it had to blow them away.
Well, Dan, here's a nice trophy.
That is a good-looking trophy, Kai.
Each and every one of you deserve this. You did your homework, you worked your tails off, and there's the result.
Thank you, buddy. For old Bruce.
They took Bruce off to the hospital. Everything's gonna be fine. All of us are feeling a little better now.
Oh, I had 8 stitches in my hand, and I've got a little tendon damage from my thumb. Is this gonna deter me from rocketry? Well, I was thinking when I was first in the hospital, I go, I'm never gonna do this again. I must have done something stupid. I was a pretty important to do, and then I realized that it had to be something that was either beyond my control or some kind of a malfunction, because I did everything right to set it up, and so I'm ready to go back and do things again.
Oh, thank you guys.
I gotta tell you, this is one of my secret recipes.
Okay, I look pretty good in that apron, you know, and I have to admit, he cooked up some pretty good burgers.
I want you guys to enjoy the same taste that we ground it up in the hamburger. Enjoy!
The hamburger wasn't done that good. Sky will never make it as a hot dog chef, but you know what? That food tasted great.
Does it? Yeah.
Next time on Master Blaster.